بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما مزيدا أما بعد. This is a refutation against these Shia men which I spoke to before. I spoke to the speaker's corner because people might say, why don't debate with him? As I have mentioned many times, we don't debate with the ru'us of Ahl Bidah. That's the way of the Salaf. The people of the book, Allah told us to debate with the people of the book. Of course, with the condition to have a knowledge. Not knowledge of our deen, like one knowledge of their deen. As for the people of Bidah, the asr, we don't debate with them. But there is exceptions. If someone comes in to seek the truth, then we explain to him. Or we are in the gathering of Al-Sunnah and the Sahib al-Batil, a person of falsehood, come in to try to refute Shubuhat, then we refute his Shubuhat right there and then. As for organizing, setting up debate with the Ru'us, the head of Al-Bidah, then this is not the way of Al-Sunnah. So this person, a blade runner, I spoke to him before. I don't remember when I came to speaker's corner, a month ago, a brother came to me, said, you know, there's a Shia person who's sincere, and can you speak to him? I said, I will speak to him. So I explained to him. I said to him, I will speak to you, but if I notice you are debating for the sake of debating, then I have to stop it. And I noticed that. I asked him for one proof. Where does he say in the Quran? I clearly follow Ahl Bayt. He was going everywhere. Then he started talking about Sahaba, line against Sahaba. He has disease in his heart, against Sahab al-Kiram, radiyallahu anhu sahabati ajma'in. So, one issue he was speaking about to one brother, and this brother, I would say he's a jahil, he should go learn, study. Because I mentioned that many times, when I do mention that people, they think Shamsi is arrogant. No, I'm not arrogant, alhamdulillah. Inshallah, I'm not. I will humble myself and ask Allah to give me sincerity and to make me humble. But a brothers keep calling me. Wallahi, brothers calling me, texting me, WhatsApping me. Shamsi, what's going on with this guy? How come he's moving to these people? Are they Salafi? They're not Salafi. Make that clear to them, they're not Salafi. So they were speaking about the issue of Tawheed. Let me speak about Tawheed, then I will clarify some shubuhat concerning Tawheed. We know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets and messengers to call people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. We have sent a messenger to every nation proclaiming, worship Allah and stay away from the false taghut. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِ إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. We have not sent a messenger to you, the meaning of the verse. We have not sent a messenger to the people before you, except to reveal to him that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. So worship me, meaning worship Allah. Na'am, likewise, the narration on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas, which is collected by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Mu'ad ibn Jabal to Yemen. He said, Ya Mu'ad, سوف تأتي قوم أهل كتاب فكن أول شيء تدعوهم إليه أن شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وفي رواية أخرى أن يوحد الله. That's a proof that a term of Tawheed. So he said, you are going to the people of the book. Let the first thing you call them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Another narration to testify, there's no one worthy of worship except Allah. Another narration, لِيُوَحِّدُ اللَّهِ, to single out Allah in worship. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created jinn and mankind except to worship me. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibn Abbas said, meaning to single out Allah in worship. So this is the da'wah of the Prophet and Messengers. The Prophet and Messengers never came to their people to tell them Allah exists, because they believed in that naturally. And the proof of that, there's many verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ قُلْ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. If you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, surely they will reply Allah. Likewise, there's many verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَنْ يُخْرُجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ وَيُخْرُجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ فَسَيَقُولُونَ اللَّهُ. And if you were to ask them, the meaning of the verse, if you were to ask them who created the heavens and the earth, and who bring the dead people from to life, and bring a life person from the dead, and who control everything in the universe, then they will reply Allah, clearly. So a person might ask, why the kuffar of Quraysh will kuffar them? If Allah clearly stated clearly that they accept that Allah is the creator, the provider, so why Allah called them disbelievers? So we can see that clearly in the verse in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Az-Zumar, وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى. Not like that Maturidi Kadab, a liar, who said no, they used to worship the idols independently. No, you liar. Because Allah clearly said, they said, the Arab pagans said, we only worship them, not the main purpose, not to get closer to them, in order to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is a clear cut. Na'am. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبَ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. He didn't say go to Ali. He didn't say go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his grave. Na'am. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so dua, supplication is belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am. Allah said in Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. You alone we worship, you alone we seek aid. So my beloved brothers and my sisters, may Allah bless you all, let us learn our tawheed, the tawheed which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet and messengers for. So when the scholars start reading the book of Allah, they come to know, based upon the qira'ah reading, that tawheed split up into three. There's tawheed al-rububiyyah, which is the lordship, believing Allah is the creator of the heavens and the earth, and other than that from Allah's actions. Likewise, there is tawheed al-uluhiyyah, tawheed al-ibadah, for the servants, for the servant to single out Allah in worship. Likewise, al-asma' wa-sifat, Allah's names and attributes. So we have to understand that's the three categories of tawheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fa'alam annahu la ilaha illallah. Knowledge first. Acknowledge that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. So one of the books that is the best book, which is a qasimatu dahab, which is strike Ahl Bid'ah's back and break their back, Kitab al-Tawheed by Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. May Allah have mercy upon him. Likewise, the Qawa'id al-Arba'. Na'am, the four principles, that book, especially the four principles, he explained to you, it's small. He explained to you the shirk of the people of shirk, and explained to you which tawheed the Prophet and messengers came with. So this is like a small talk about the tawheed, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That Allah said in Surah Zumar to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was revealed to you and to those who came before you, So Allah addressed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that it was revealed to you and to those who came before you that if you were to commit shirk, all your actions would be nullified. Allah addressed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Na'am, so tawheed is very important. Na'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about his prophet. What did I say? Ya qawmi i'budullah, ma lakum min ilahin ghayruh. Oh my people, my dear people, worship Allah. You have no one besides him. Na'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wa idha Allahu wahdahu shma'azzat qulubul ladina la yu'minuna bil akhirah. When Allah is called by himself, do you know who gets angry? The people don't believe in Allah, the last day. Na'am, and when someone associates matters with Allah, they become very happy. So now let us ask ourselves, who calls upon other than Allah? Our Ahl-Sunnah Salafiyyun. Allah mentioned clearly, Allah wahdahu, wahdahu, not with someone else, shma'azzat. Even the term shma'azzat, they become like stressful. They become depressed because Allah is being called by himself. Subhanallah. How dare you say you are following the Ahl Bayt. You are following Ahl Shaytan. No Ahl Bayt, let me make this clear to you. No Ahl Bayt you are following. So this is, I'm referring to this, a man who is kadab, lying against the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger of Allah. As for the Shia, there's some of them are laymen. They don't know. I'm not speaking about them. They don't know, they're masakeen. I met some of them here. Like I spoke to one of them last year. Well, I was explaining to him, he was listening. But the head of them, Ya la hayyahum Allah. I make it clear. La hayyahum Allah. We have to make that clear because they are worse. They stab us on the back. They are lying against Allah. They will try to use the verse of the Quran because the kuffar that are clear, they will not deceive the Muslims. But the worst people who comes as we are Muslims misquoting the verse. So we make that clear. Tawheed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us. There's a verse in Surah Ghafir. Na'am, Allah said, the meaning of the verse, Allah said, call upon your Lord. Na'am. And your Lord will answer you. Call upon your Lord and your Lord will answer you. Allah didn't say call upon Ali, call upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But a person might say, there's a verse in the Quran, Allah said, if they wrong themselves, they came to you and seek forgiveness and you sought forgiveness for them and they sought forgiveness from Allah. This verse anyway speaking about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's lifetime. Why I'm saying that? because none of the Sahaba, likewise Ahl Bayt, Al-Hassan, Wal-Hussein, and Ali, went to Prophet Muhammad's grave, and they said, oh, Messenger of Allah, seek forgiveness for us. Because if you are saying, that's what it means, even if he passed away, therefore, because Allah is telling everyone, Allah is, that is a khitab, which is for everyone, na'am. So now, if you are saying for everyone, including Ali and Hassan Hussein, therefore, you have shown me clear cut with the authentic narration that Ali, Hassan, Hussein went to Prophet Muhammad's grave and they said, oh, Messenger of Allah, seek forgiveness on our behalf. Because that would be, even logically, that doesn't make any sense. Because why? What about people live in India? People live in Algeria, poor people. So if they commit sin, they have to go to Prophet's grave. If they don't have no money, so there's no forgiveness. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. So logically, naqlan wa aqlan will refute you. Naqlan wa aqlan, based upon textual proofs and intellectual proof, will refute you. So they were speaking to this brother. They said to him, a brother said, you can, and they mix it between the tawassul and the istighatha. Let us define what is a tawassul and what is an istighatha. A tawassul, when a person say, oh Allah, I ask you in the name of Muhammad, or because of the status of Muhammad, or the status of so and so. That is a tawassul. And that is, which is not a shirk, but it's bid'ah. Because there's no verse in the Quran. Allah mentioned about his prophets and messengers, likewise about the righteous people saying, oh our Lord, because of the states of your prophets, because of your prophet, forgive us. No. Rabbana aghfir lana. Allahumma aghfir lana. Everything, Allahumma, ya Allah, ya Rabb. Always that address Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forsake, for the asking forgiveness. So that is a tawassul, but that is bid'i. Why? Because as I mentioned, it's not the way Prophet did it, that you go to ask in the name of Prophet Muhammad or because someone's status. You just, Allah subhanahu said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. If my servant ask about me, then I'm near. Call upon me and I will respond to your call. As for istighatha, when you ask the person to make dua for you, na'am, you ask the person to help you, to remove the hardship from you. You call istighatha, because what is the difference between istighatha and isti'ana? Istighatha is in a hardship. So you seek help in a hardship. Isti'ana is general. So istighatha, so now we seek it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, وَإِن تَسْتَغِيثُونَ رَبَّكُمْ. Na'am, and you sought aid from your Lord. Na'am. So we seek aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for seeking istighatha from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which only Allah is able to do, then this is a shirk billah, associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if a person is alive, example of that, I'm going through hardship and I see someone who's completely paralyzed and they say, oh so and so help me. There's two things. Maybe I'm majnoon, or I believe this person somehow he has superpower to help me, even though he's completely paralyzed. So now, istighatha, as the ulama mentioned, na'am, that is permissible in one thing. If a person is alive and is able to help you. The proof of that, because Shia asked the brother, he said, what is the proof? Now let me establish something. When Allah said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. In Arabic language, what does it mean? الْحَصْرُ وَالْقَصْرُ. Meaning that we only seek aid from Allah. We only worship Allah. So person might say, so you're not allowed to seek aid from other than Allah? No, we say, no, we are allowed. What is the proof? When you read the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Musa, فَاسْتَغَاثَهُ الَّذِي مِنْ شِيَعَتِهِ عَلَى الَّذِي هُوَ مِنْ عَدُوِهِ. Na'am. So that is a proof that istighatha, if someone is alive and is able, then he can do it. Because if that was a shirk, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam would not give him istighatha. So that is a clear-cut proof where ulama as-sunnah derive that there is a time when istighatha is permissible. I will not help you that. Na'am, we start making up stuff, then we start looking for the adillah. No, we have the adillah, then we implement it. But however, the brother that I spoke to you, or the brother that was speaking to him, he didn't have ilm. He was all over the place. Allah al-musta'an. I want to advise my brother, study. So that is one thing. At tawassul, we are allowed to do tawassul with our good deeds. The proof that Allah said in the Quran about the believers, رَبَّنَا آمَنَّا فَاغْفِرْ لَنَا. So what they said, we believe that is a rash action, so forgive us. You see, another one, but Allah's name's attribute. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. Na'am, to Allah belongs the beautiful names, so call him with it. And likewise, if someone is righteous, the proof of that, the hadith of Umar, the author of Umar al-Khattab, when he told Abdullah, when he told Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib to pray or to supplicate to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to make it rain for them. This general, but to advise you again, because I'm not gonna stay here for 2 hours, but inshallah maybe we'll do series of refuting the doubt that this man tried to bring. Person might say, why don't go debate? We don't debate with Al-Bid. I spoke to him, it's not sincere. Line against Muawiyah, say Muawiyah is munafiq. I'm gonna make another video about this adalat al-Sahaba. This, how many verses on the Quran Allah praising the Sahaba? I will mention it after. So there's one thing. So it was about tawassul. That's so the proof that we tawassul, we that the Al-Sunnah use from the Quran. نعم ربنا آمنا فاغفر لنا وإلا الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها. نعم. Also the story of Yusuf عليه الصلاة والسلام, when his brothers came to Yaqub, they said, ask our Lord to forgive us, the meaning of the verse. So that is permissible. Alhamdulillah, Ahl Sunnah, we derive our proofs from the Quran and from the prophetic tradition. So we have to understand that. And as I've mentioned always, go back to learn about this issue more. Go back to my teacher's website, Abu Khadija, Abu Iyad. Naam, they have the website of Aqeedah, in the Abu Khadija's website. So you go back and read it. And there was a problem with, look, subhanAllah, when this Shia was debating that brother, who was not Salafi, I'll make it clear. Naam, he was quoting someone, Abdul Rahman Hassan. We said, look, Abdul Rahman Hassan. Naam, he was quoting him about the hadith. Yeah, the hadith. Naam, that's why Al-Sunnah advise. We don't organize and setting up a debate with Al-Bidah, the Ru'us, the heads. Because look, he's trying to use the Shubha, which our brother couldn't refute as well in details. The hadith they try to use is the hadith of Al-A'ma. What is the hadith of Al-A'ma? The Shia man lied. He said he asked for Sallam. No, that is istighatha. No, he done tawassul. He scared Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, make dua for me. So the meaning of the hadith, Prophet said, go make wudu and you make the dua. Oh Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, we ask you, like, astashfa' bika wa atawassalu bika bi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Here, what does it mean? Bi dua. Because when you put in the context, he asked Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to supplicate to him. Even though some scholars differ about this hadith, some scholars say it's a da'if, but for the sake of argument, that this hadith is not clear cut. And what Allah said in the Quran, Allahu Akbar. هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله. نعم, until the end of the verse. So the people who have disease in their heart, what they do? They go to the unclear verses, the unclear ahadith. Clear verses, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call upon Allah directly. Clear ahadith, when Prophet said to Ibn Abbas, Ya ghulam, إذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. Clear cut hadith. If you seek aid from Allah. If you call upon Allah. He didn't say, oh my son, when I die, come to my grave, call upon me, I will call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, Allah always directs us to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. Because istighatha is an act of worship. But as you have mentioned, sometimes you can seek istighatha from someone who is alive, who is able. As I have mentioned, the proof in Surah Al-Qasas. فَاسْتَغَاثَهُ الَّذِي مِنْ شِعَاتِ عَلَّذِي مِنْ عَدُوِهِ. نعم. So if that was a shirk, Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام would not have the Israelites. So that is some refutation against the Shia man who kadab. نعم, he lied. Allah guide us and guide him. But I'm here to expose the ru'us of Al-Bidah, because it's ras. The way I deal with the layman different than the way we deal with ru'us. And this is the way of the Salaf. This is the way of Al-Sunnah. Because these people, we have to clean the house from inside before you clean it from outside. Understand? Our house full of this Al-Bidah. Like that guy with him, Saracen, another Sahibu Bidah. I spoke to him privately and he promised me. He said, I will contact you, Shamsi, and I'll come speak to you. But you keep spreading your lies, your nonsense against Salafis openly, so I'm here to refute you openly. That's what Sheikh Ibn Baz, may Allah have mercy upon him. He said, don't let the people of the evil take places and occupy place and try to spread their evil. We have to participate on those places and refute them. What do I mean that by that? Not sit with Al-Bidah in one platform. Let me make it clear. Because you know Al-Bidah, we try to cut you something. Na'am? We don't share platform with Al-Bidah. Na'am? So I hope I make it clear. Allah give us sincerity, and I will look to the video again about Sahaba. We're gonna make another video proving the adilla from the Quran. But before that, let me read something to you from the book of the Shia about Taqiyya. Shia, they believe in the Taqiyya. Naam, Shia believe in the Taqiyya. That they believe is a kadib. The book is by Ihsan Ilahi Dahir. This book is by one of scholars, Ihsan Ilahi Dahir. A person might say you are using a Sunni scholar. No. He mentioned the page, he mentioned the publisher. So you, what you do, come and try to expose him. You had to kill him, rahimahullah ta'ala, because you couldn't refute him. You had to put a bomb to kill him, may Allah have mercy upon him. Yeah, and you're claiming that Salafi terrorists, why every terrorist organization are Sunni. You're a liar. Hezbollah, they are Shia. Naam? Hezbollah, not Hezbollah, Hezbollah. That's what you have to call them. Naam? Okay, I was going to mention something. Naam? So that's narration. He says, La imana lah. مَنْ لَا تَقِيَّ لَا نعم. So you have no belief if you have no تَقِيَّ to lie. نعم. And the reason that some of the Shia scholars hate Yasir al-Khabith is not because they disagree with him. No, because they believe it's not the right time to speak out, to speak openly about our belief. Because they from their belief, as Sadduq mentioned, Ibn Babweh, I can't remember the name, mentioned that you have to wait for the Imam, the last Imam to appear, then you speak openly. Naam, so this is a kadib. Naam, even they lied against Yazid. Yazid, I'm not gonna say he's a righteous man, he's the best man. You lied against him. Naam, so let us read something to you from their book. They say this is Kitab al-Hujja min Usul al-Kafi al-Kulayni. He says, Kulayni said, Inna qawla Allah ta'ala sa'ala sa'ilun bi'adabin waqi' lil-kafirina biwilayati Ali laysa lahu dafi'. Hakada. والله نزل بها والله نزل بها جبرائيل عليه السلام على محمد. So from their book to show you they believe the Quran has been changed. But when they come here they hide, they lie. نعم. So if you believe the Quran has not been changed, you have to make takfir on this khabith, al-Kulayni. Because there's many stuff in his book clear cut disbelief. He said the verse, which is the Surah Al-Ma'arij, the origin of the verse was revealed that the person asked concerning the punishment. نعم. And Allah mentioned in that verse, bi wilayati Ali. Naam, bi wilayati Ali. That verse, where is this verse? It doesn't exist. They wouldn't have it. But they say, yeah, he said that's the way it was revealed. And there's many, many. Let me quote to you. Look what they said. Whoever rejects Imama, what is he? Naam. This is As-Sidduq bin Babweh Al-Qummi. In his book, I'tiqadat. This is from the belief. This is not a book of history I'm reading. This is from the belief. This, they believe. He said, اعتقادنا في من جحد إمامة أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب والأئمة من بعده أنه كمن جحد نبوة جميع الأنبياء واعتقادنا في من أقر بأمير المؤمنين وأنكر واحدا من بعده من الأئمة إنه بمنزلة من أقر بجميع الأنبياء وأنكر نبوة نبينا محمد. أعوذ بالله من ذلك. So this from their belief, he said, our belief about someone who rejects the Imam of Ali bin Abi Talib or the A'imma who came after him is like someone rejecting the prophethood of the prophets. Likewise, from our belief, if any person accepted the Imama of Amir Mu'minin Ali and rejected the rest of the A'imma, is like someone who believed in the prophets and rejected the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So to them, if you reject Imam, you're kafir. But when they come here, they come with a taqiyya, lying. That's why the Christians try to use it against us. No, our taqiyya and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in a time they try to kill you. You know they try to harm you. That's why Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahu wa ta'ala rebuked Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in when he said to him, why did you respond to the mihna of khalq al-Quran that the Quran is created? He said the hadith of Ammar ibn Yasir. He said Ammar ibn Yasir was tortured. But as for you, you were threatened. Naam? But Shia, no one threatened them here. They come, no one gonna touch them, but they lie. From their deed to lie, it's from the aqidah. They have to lie. And there's many proof when Abu Ja'far al-Sadiq, he said something that in their book, then he went and he whispered to one of his followers is different than what he said openly. Because it's from their belief that you're not allowed to speak openly. And other than that, from their kadib, and he says, Madi Ali is not shirk. When you say Madi Ali, you're asking help.
It's like someone who says, oh, Jesus, help me. Then he said, no, ask his intention. That's the dire is ma'roof. It's a clear cut. It's not a person that you see prostrate in the grave. Maybe you go ask him what to do. He said, no, maybe I'll drop something. That's why I want to prostrate to get here. I was open. This clearly is called upon Ali. Na'am, and I shirk. Allah said, look this verse, subhanAllah. Wallahi, my brothers and my sisters, also the Shia who are sincere, take my advice, read the Quran. Wallahi, every time I speak to Shia, I said, read the Quran. When Allah has been called by himself, شمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة. Those who doesn't believe in the last day, they become angry, frustrated. But when someone has been called beside Allah, they become happy. Who does that? Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, Ahl al-Hadith wal-Athar, Salafiyun, call upon Allah alone. That's why Shia get angry with us. But if we call someone with Allah, they will become very happy. Na'am, and I have mentioned for more details, go back to the website. I've mentioned of my Ustad Abu Iyad, Na'am, Abu Hakim, Bela Davis, Abdul Ilah, and may Allah give us sincerity. سبحانك الله بحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وصلى الله على امامنا ونبينا محمد وقرة اعيننا وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا
بارك الله فيكم.